This is how it looks in natural light. You cannot see even a freaking thing on my face, like even a freaking spot. So it's that flawless. That is where I have most of my darkness. Hi everyone and welcome back. And if you're new here, hi, welcome. Join the enthusiasm, subscribe. So today I am going to show you how I do my base makeup, like primer, foundation, moisturizer, and prepping my skin and all that stuff. Now stick very close to the screen if you are a beginner, and I am going to explain each and everything. I am going to show you all the products for different skin types. I have just incorporated all of that in this video. Now a quick disclaimer, these are the steps, like the steps that I'm going to discuss in this video are the steps that I do when I want my makeup to look flawless, like completely flawless, like flawless like a goddess. So I do all of these steps when I want my makeup to look very flawless, and you know, sometimes I am also lazy. So I don't do all of these steps every time, only like for special occasions maybe. Yes, when I want my makeup to look flawless, just then. So don't come for me if you do not find all of these steps in all of my videos, because here I try to create flawless at its best. So obviously I can't do it each and every time. I try to do it, but you know, sometimes I'm out of products, I'm out of my mind, my freaking mind. So yes. So without any further blabbering, let's snap right into the video. Step one is obviously going to be skincare. Skincare is a must. If you want a flawless base, you have to have a good skin. Now, I'm not saying that you have to have perfect skin. Otherwise, you don't need to apply makeup, alright? You don't need all the full coverage stuff. You don't need to see this video. So yes, you have to have your skin at its best. But here by skincare, I mean prepping your skin. So I generally use a cleanser or a sheet mask before applying my makeup. So these are very, very nourishing, and I generally pre-cool my sheet mask for 5 minutes, not very cold. What this will do is that it will just minimize the pores. The mask that I use today is the turmeric plus coconut for revitalized and radiant skin from Nykaa. I've already used it. So you don't want anything to be present on your face before applying your makeup, before applying your base. So your face has to be really very clean. After step one, let's come to step two, which is moisturizing your face. And I know my hair looks really fucked up, but yes, I think I should have curled it after doing all of this, but now moisturizing is very important for all skin types. Just keep an eye on the combination of products that you're using. For example, if you're having an oily skin, you're using a very dewy kind of a primer, you're using a very oily moisturizer, and then packing on a dewy foundation, it's going to look all caked up. And it's not going to, obviously you will face a meltdown, complete meltdown. Now if you're having a dry skin and you're using a very oil-free moisturizer, very mattifying primer, and then very poreless kind of a foundation which is very mattifying, you will end up making your fine lines very, very prominent. So the thing is to make combinations that actually work for your skin and stop following each and everything blindly, because you have to like study your skin and then make combinations according to that. For example, I have a very, you know, dry combination kind of a skin during summer, so I obviously use a very lightweight moisturizer after doing all of that, you know, mask and all that. So I use a very lightweight moisturizer, and then I use two kind of primers to treat different areas differently. And then I use a very demi matte kind of a foundation. So that basically works for me during summers. So that is what I am going to do here. First of all, I am going to moisturize. Stab this in. Now I use a primer water, and I also use a mattifying primer because my T-zone needs a mattifying primer so bad. So I just love this one. This is the Maybelline Master Prime by Face Studio. This is the Blur Plus Smooth Primer. Before that, I just want to spray a little bit of Fix Plus. So I either use the MAC Fix Plus or the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Water. But if you're looking for a drugstore alternative, I really like this Wet n Wild Photo Focus Primer Water Spray. This is really good for dry skin. I used it all like winter, like the whole winter, and this was really good. Right now I'm just going to spray the Fix Plus because this is like a go-to thing that I have to have. So next, I just take my sponge, which is already damp and clean, and I'm just going to press this into my skin, especially in this area because this is very dry. So now if you touch your skin, it's actually tacky, which I really like because the foundation actually like sticks really properly to your skin. Now next, I am going to blur out my T-zone, like literally blur out. So I'm just using this Maybelline Master Prime. I don't know why, I just like doing that. Now if you're looking for the most flawless base in the world, make sure that you don't have any hair on your skin. Especially just shave your mustache and your sideburns. It will make you look more flawless. But right now I have just shaved out my mustache, but I have not like done my sideburns. I'm very lazy if it comes to sideburns. I have to wax it out. For that I use a hard wax, and I just don't want to do it because it's so much work. Now next is color correcting, and if you're very new to color correcting, you don't know anything about color correcting, now from that summary it's very clear that the orange corrector is used to correct dark circles or darkness, you know, for medium and deep skin tones. And for lighter skin tones, you should actually use a peach corrector for your dark circles if you have extreme dark circles. Now just don't misuse color correctors, or you will end up adding an unnecessary layer to your skin, which you do not need. Just do not need. I'm just going to apply a little bit. Now for contouring, I'm just going to mix these two. This is the LA Girl Pro Conceal HD in Dark Cocoa, and then Pure Beige, which is my concealer color, and then this is my nothing. It's my nothing because it's very dark for me. So I mixed all of that up with this brush. I'm just like oh shit, that's too much. So again, I'm just gonna take my sponge and I'm like, next I'm just going to conceal under my eyes. I always like to use concealer below foundation nowadays because it just gives you a very natural finish. Now let's set the face, and for setting the face I have a few powders that I want to recommend. So number one is this Coty Airspun. Smells really, I mean it smells a lot, but it's a good powder and I don't have any problem with the scent. Next is this Wet n Wild super affordable contouring palette. This thing with your sponge is so good for your face. The next and the ultimate favorite is this Fit Me powder. And this one is in the shade light medium. And especially in these two areas, because it makes my forehead look very large. So I'm just going to set this too. So this is the look that I created, mauvey at its fullest. If you want to see the tutorial, it's on my Instagram. If you do not follow me on Instagram, please follow me on Instagram. So I think I have mentioned each and everything about how to create the base for this kind of a look. Like it's completely full coverage, it will cover all your flaws, nothing is visible, no matter it's fluorescent light, it's natural light, it's yellow, it's warm, whatever, in whichever light you go, it's going to look flawless. So, and it will last all day. So I think I've mentioned everything. Now if you have any queries, please mention it in the comment section below. Please mention it, do not hesitate. And if you want to see how I created this eye look, please head to my Instagram. I have a mini tutorial over there. So yes, that's it for the video. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you don't like the video, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit that notification bell. And if you really like this video, then please share this video. Bye.